1970s was the era of look-at-me fashion and nothing was off limits. Fur sequins and the brightest prints were proudly worn every day. There were many icons. Let's check them out. Farrah Fawcett.
Oh, loved her.
Amazing. Look at her hair. Debbie Harry.
Yes.
Stevie Nicks. And Cher.
Who I reckon you're channeling today, Tash?
Yeah,
I've been looking at you today, don't you reckon?
Fake eyelashes are so heavy.
but it looks good. It's very Cher, I reckon.
Thank you. Good. I got you, babe. Now, we've got our very own fashion icon here this morning, Henry Roth.
Hello, how are you? Lovely to see you.
You're showing us some fabulous 70s fashion. Where do we begin?
We start with Ella, and she is wearing a really amazing Poochy-inspired Midi frock. And she looks absolutely resplendent. It's a real floral. She looks absolutely elegant. She's got a tarjay bag and platform shoes. And the most important thing is the hair is flipped back. She's looking natural and fantastic. And that really translates for 2016.
Absolutely. You can wear that today.
Next, we have Jane. Take a look at this look. Jane Curtis, a Melbourne stylist and a painter.
Oh.
And she has got the must-have hair. She's got those shorts. The shorts and that pullover is from Yesteryear. She's got the fringe suede coat from Tarjay. She's got the glasses, she's got the fro, and she is ready to do lots of love and happiness, because it was all about extremes in the 70s.
Yeah.
It was all about love. Our next is Ivana. Have a look at this part. Now, Ivana is wearing the must-have leopard print jacket from Jane Curtis, and she's wearing this beautiful pantsuit, which is in teal from Dizengoff. Isn't that? You could wear that today, couldn't you, ladies?
Yeah, oh, my goodness.
Absolutely.
I want all of
and
that.
She's got that beautiful scarf from Target, and she looks absolutely resplendent.
Flair
and again, 2016.
Flair pantsuit.
Flair pantsuit. They were on. They were on. Absolutely.
And lots of leopard.
And we have Robbo. Now, Robbo is coming. He's got the Saturday Night Fever going, and he's got that beautiful swirl. The shirt is from Target, which is a bodysuit. He's got the glasses from Jane Curtis. He's got the moves. He's got the look. He's got the bro. He's in business. Fantastic. Because in the 70s, ladies, it was all about a one monochrome look. It looked fantastic. And finally, we have Caroline, and she is wearing a Poochy-inspired hat. She's got a gorgeous Yesteryear floral frock. She's got the belt and shoes from Target, and she just looks absolutely beautiful. The hair was flicked back, the makeup, look at the pink makeup. And I tell you what, if you were to walk into Windsor or Brunswick Street or Oxford Street in Sydney, that would be quite different, wouldn't it?
It would be very different.
About so much what do you think?
They're all lined up, looking absolutely fantastic. What do you think, Tash? What do you think, ladies?
Yeah, very pretty.
Fantastic, right? A big applause to all the people involved. And also, the wigs are by Shiny Wigs in Flinders Street in Melbourne. What do you think? What do you think?
Henry, I think this is fab. Ida and I were chatting before about so much of this is in fashion now.
It is. It's really gone into the... It's flipped over, and I think people didn't realise.
I should have hung on to all my 70s clothes, shouldn't I? I could be wearing them again. What's so nice, I think, is it's very feminine.
And I think it is, and I think it's a real celebration of figure as well, because you've got every shape, you've got every look possible, and I think the thing as well is it's a celebration of femininity.
It is.
Because it was the year when people were so extreme. It went from Pacmans to Walkmans. Mm. It went non-Vietnam. Mm. It had Nixon was resigning, and people were just over it all.
Yes.
It was people power.
Yeah.
And I think that's so interesting.
And Ida, you were mentioning earlier that often in the workplace, certain workplaces, pants were not acceptable. Is
no,
that right?
at Consolidated Press, where we produced Cleo and the Weekly, we were forbidden to wear pants. We did not.
Is that right?
Pants. And even though they showed pants on Paper Giants, that was wrong.
Oh.
There was a ban. So Frank forbade pants. We all had to wear skirts or dresses. So out of work, we all wore pants. Mm-hmm. You know,
it was a bit of a rebel.
We loved it.
Perhaps Charlie's Angels was a symbol of that absolute negativity of having to be, you know, put into a uniform. And so when women were empowered, they did wear pants and they wore slacks and they were wearing pantsuits because you couldn't at work.
It probably had something to do with that, but it was such an easy way to dress.
Yes.
And you could dress it up or dress it down and you could still be feminine.
Mm. And you know what? Because they're your earrings, aren't they, Ita?
These are my earrings.
Oh, these are actually
earrings.
I'm 19. Yeah, they're somewhere 1977, 76. Mm. I got them there in Double Bay here in Sydney. Yes. And of course, I've kept them all these years because they don't date.
Beautiful.
My tip is hang on to what you've got because it always comes back.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Henry, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me. Thank you, everyone. Absolute pleasure. Fantastic. And thanks to the models. Fantastic.
Yeah, big round of applause. They were fabulous. And Robbo's still dancing.
We could be dancing.